Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to the final game on day three of the 2017 International WFTDA Championships here in Dallas, Texas. My name is Shady Hawkins. I'm joined by Scarlett Ohercha, and we are going to be helped out by Justice Feelgood Marshall. And we are so excited to bring you to this game, and we've got something really special for you. So let's take a look real quick on how these teams have reached this point in this journey. The Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners entered this 2017 Division I playoffs ranked number 6 in the WFTDA and with the number 2 seeding position. After having a bye in round 1, Texas would face off against the Dallas Derby Devils amidst a crowd as big as the state itself. Texas would continue to stand tall, maintaining Lone Star supremacy, beating Dallas 248-89. They would then face off against the number 3 seed from St. Louis, Missouri, arch rival. Overcoming arch rival's unique blocking strategy, Texas continued their domination 209-119.
And now we're going to take you to the Southern Hemisphere to the Victorian Roller Derby All-Stars. Victorian Roller Derby League from Victoria, Australia entered the tournament as the number 1 seed, earning a bye in the first round. In round 2, a very physical Philly roster was no match for Victorian's mechanically precise defense, Victorian earning a win in that game 314-50. Then yesterday, we saw the team from down under face the number 4 seed Minnesota, icing the competition 329-36.
Now on day 3 of the final Division I playoff of 2017, Victoria will face off against the Texecutioners in what is sure to be a memorable milestone on the path to the Hydra in Philadelphia.
Absolutely.
So we are, I mean, you just kind of saw a little bit of a smattering of everything that we've gotten the opportunity to see up close and personal here at this tournament. And it's going to be a great game. But before we do any of that, we're going to take you to Chip Queso on the floor right now for team rosters.
It is my proud pleasure to introduce to you from Austin, Texas, representing the Texas Roller Girls, the Texecutioners! Number 3, Olivia Shootin' John. Number 7, Jackie Daniels. 100 is CeCe Boom. Number 12, DeBella DeBall. Number 15 is Trauma. 16 is Asia Gare. 202 is Freight Train. 22 is Polygon. 27 is Peace War. Number 33 is Gravy Baby. 34 is Bo Jackson. Number 420 is Stoneher. Number 5, Smarty Pants. And number 55, Hoss the Boss. Your Texecutioners. Hailing from Melbourne, Australia, the Victorian Roller Derby All-Stars. Number 0, Ivy Knivey. Number 10, Biceptual. Number 11, Sarah Chambers. Number 128 is Amy Booth. Number 14, Christy Demons. Hey. Number 20, Lorray Evans. 2806, Danny Darko. 307, Ashayna Searleson. Number 358, Jana Nuku. 38 is Bone Shaker. 4,000, Anna Paveuova. Number 54 is Lady Trample. 66 is Screwberry Moore. And number 85 is Bianca Scarietta. Victorian All-Stars. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in 2013, VRDL went to Tucson and the Dust Devil. Then they made their way.
Ladies and gentlemen, we would also like to take this moment to introduce you to our officiating staff for the evening. We are going to have our non-skating officials being comprised of May the Force, Nora Leaf, Doc Psycho, Chanel Number Die, Torque Mama, Fill in the Blank, Wizard of Laws, FN Zebra, Buenas Tardes, Jezebel O'Kitty, Shebra, Bumblebee Brand, and Coconut Chanel.
And our referees, our head referee is Laddie, followed by Izzy Demented, Wernher Von Bombed, Searson, Bruise Almighty, Interrobang, You're Did, Trial and Terror, Oliver DePlace. That's our skating referee crew, and this is sure to be an exciting game. We're ready to hit the track to close out what's been a really exciting tournament, JD.
It really has. So Dallas having two upsets at this playoffs this year from Dallas Derby Devils getting some of the upset action this season. So hopefully not too many people crying into their brackets. But isn't that what the game is made of?
I think that's what any of these sorts of things are. And I don't think it's any surprise to see the two top teams that were seeded in this tournament to be playing in the final game. But we know how important this game is. Just because they're going to champs doesn't mean that they are going to rest on their laurels. That seeding really has a benefit once you get to that final championship round, or championship tournament, I should say, in the quest for the Hydra. Now, I think Victorian is out for blood because they feel like they've got something to prove. Ranked number one in the WFTDA currently, and I think they want to bring the Hydra down to the Southern Hemisphere.
You know, it probably is about time for the Hydra to apply for a passport. I think it'd be definitely an interesting thing to spectate, but I think, you know what, I'm going to have to disagree just a little bit on one thing, and that's that Victorian has something to prove. I think they've proven plenty over this past season. I think really what they're going to be doing is they're just going to be maintaining. So they have set the standard for themselves, and that bar is awful high.
Indeed it is. But, you know, they've gotten to this point with a lot of hard work and some really unique strategies and different shapes and various things that they've developed completely independent of the rest of the world, essentially. And this is an opportunity for us to focus on the WFTDA as an international body and really show that this is an international movement.
Totally agree. Totally agree. And any team that can accomplish what Victorian has accomplished is has a right to absolutely be proud. And we actually just saw a couple of our skaters on the side, mainly Shayna Sarrelson, doing a little dance. To be here.
I would dare call that a happy dance. I was going to say that was a group happy dance.
That was a pretty happy dance. So Sarrelson, I got an opportunity to speak with her a little bit before the game, while we met prior to this broadcast, and definitely mind on the game, but very, very excited, very ready for it. Texas just as ready, and it looks like everyone else out on the track is ready. And we are going to start this game off, it looks like, from both of these teams, as we're coming up 20 seconds until the first whistle. Freight Train being chosen to wear the star first, hardly any surprise there. And Lady Trample for Victorian Roller Derby wearing the star number 54. So if you're just joining us, Victorian Roller Derby in the blue with white, Texas Roller Girls, Texecutioners in the white with black with a little bit of red on there.
And the whistle blows, so we are ready to get underway. Now, these two jammers have two very different jam styles, so I'm curious to see how this works because their defenses have also been doing very different things this weekend.
That's definitely something of worth noting, and here we see Lady Trample coming out first with impunity, taking the outside line after a lateral movement. Lead jammer going first to Victoria. Freight Train finding the inside line for drive through.
I think that she was actually stashing the star to get through, and I thought she was, you know, going to attempt a pass, and I was thinking, you know, first jam out, but, you know, just a star stash to get through that pack. Lady Trample executing that oh-so-stellar clock management from Victoria, calling it off after 2 points.
We're going to have Christy Demons now take the line for Victoria, and Haas the Boss wearing the star. Haas taking off the second half of their game with arch rival. And just as the whistle blows, you see Victorian scoop backwards almost to absorb the impending pressure from Haas the Boss. But out up front, it's going to be Texas defense holding Christy Demons into the apex. But Christy Demons breaking apart that Texas tripod and on the outside lane for lead jammer going to Victoria.
Now, I got to note, Haas the Boss had some really interesting foot and leg placement there at the back of that pack. But here we see, oh, that phenomenal teamwork there by Texas, who follow-up hit actually sent Christy Demons out of bounds there at turn one. Looked like she was going to stay inside, Matrix style, leaning all the way back. That flexibility is so important in modern roller derby.
Certainly is, as Christy Demon shows that flexibility, pushing through the center, but able to quickly adjust and agilely just leap to the side, is able to recover and is now leaning up against the Texas tripod at the front of the pack. We are sitting, coming up on the 28-minute mark in jam number two of this game.
Haas has removed the helmet cover from her helmet, and we have two pretty strictly defined defensive formations. We've got Texas in a box at the front and Victoria with that tripod, and just one by one shoving Haas to the infield over and over again.
And we are going to have a star pass confirmed, so that's going to be to number 15, Trauma. Christy Demon's not going to allow Trauma to do any work, calling the jam off, and it is a five-point jam for Victoria. Noteworthy that Texas holding Victoria to single pass.
And let's look at this replay. Here we see an assist that's been so critical to Victoria here. She just barrels in and makes room for her jammer while the rest of the Texies grab, all getting together in that three formation, all three following through all the way to that outside line to hold back the stop the bleeding, so to speak.
Lady Trample wearing the star now for Victoria. Gravy Baby for Texas. And Lady Trample is lead jammer, but did have to reassess a pass beyond Smarty Pants. Lady Trample now on a scoring pass. Will be re-entering the track just about, re-enter the pack, rather, just about now.
She gets shoved out right by the pivot line. And I got to say, Lady Trample is one that has a really unique jamming style. So I'm curious to see how Texas answers that, because it's a little different than most jammers. You'll see her with a lot of lateral movement, a lot of really straight leg movement, and she tends to be more vertical than most jammers you see who really focus on getting that center of gravity down and getting nice and low. But still, Lady Trample executing that Victorian clock management with 3 points. And here we see that's right after that lateral move to get out to the front. And that chasse to the outside with a big smile on her face.
So Smarty Pants just not finishing that block all the way to the edge at the top of the apex.
We have a scrum start on the line. We haven't seen a whole lot of that.
And just as they do that, they back it right up and put pressure on the line. Ivy Knivey wearing the star for Victoria. Olivia Shootin-John for Texas. So based on this this angle, you can kind of see jammers seeking for spaces, but blockers just taking up the entire track. Now both of these jammers trying to use the same line. We do have an empty 888 penalty box, as everyone has their full complement of blockers.
It looks like OJ gets shoved to the inside and then caught behind a tag team of two and now four Victorian blockers. And Ivy Knivey manages to use the chaos and strip off those Texas blockers one by one and get through to grab lead jammer status.
Ivy Knivey hitting the pack hard with the shoulder. Shoulder going right into Polygon and Peace War. Now finding an outside opening, but Texas quickly closes that with their tripod, but isn't really able to fully, and now they are able to fully lock in that tripod for Ivy Knivey, both having to drop a blocker, but now number 66, Screw Barrymore from Victoria, coming up to play offense. Texas now having to contend with that added factor. In the meantime, in the back of the pack, Olivia Shootin-John, having removed the star, is now one blocker left to go at the front of the pack. That blocker is out of play. They're going to have to let Olivia go.
And this is still Olivia Shootin-John's initial pass. So, we have a back blocking penalty called on Ivy Knivey. So we're going to have a full two-minute jam. This is going to be critical for the Texecutioners because they have yet to score. And this is where that change can happen. Look at those shoulders, one after another, by number 66, Screw Barrymore from Victorian, just relentless on OJ.
So Screw Barrymore taking OJ all the way to the line. And now we're going to see Texas's offense be able to do a little work. And again, it's Screw Barrymore at the front.
And with that pass, OJ grabs another 5 points, and we have a tie game, folks, here in jam number four, which is about to expire. So Victoria had a lot of those short, sweet, slow scoring but quick jams. And Texas able to make up and match that score with two passes for two grand slams. And here's where we see that penalty happen for Ivy Knivey. And trying to get up and break on through, but she does get called. Heading into jam number five, who's jamming, Shady?
That's going to be Christy Demons and Freight Train. Christy Demons coming out off the line almost immediately, earning lead. Jammer Freight Train struggling on that lane number one, now looking for lane number three, but is having to fight a revolutionary box at the front of the pack. Christy Demons now has re-entered on a scoring pass. Texas Tripod in the back, trying to hold Christy Demons back.
We have a box formation from Victoria up in the front, and that's not what you normally see from them. You typically see that anchored tripod with an assist. Christy Demons gets shoved to the inside and calls it off pretty quickly. And I got to say, both of these teams have great track awareness and constantly aware of where that line is. And something you'll see on our track is the Rydell logo. So right here we see Christy Demons trying to push through and notices where her feet are on that line, pulled back behind Texas's defense anchored there. And we want you to go visit Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in roller skates for over 70 years. Check out rydellskates.com.
Victoria now putting out Lady Trample. Texas putting out Haas the Boss to wear the star for their respective teams. Haas the Boss taking a tumble on the inside line. Lady Trample working to the back. Texas using that four blocker, but spin move around on the inside. Lady Trample is not going to get it. Forearm to Lady Trample. Texas now on a power jam. Haas the Boss now with an opportunity for lead jammer. Peace War trying to give Haas the Boss the whip. If anybody can whip, it's Haas the Boss. One blocker, two blockers left to go.
Victorian really speeding up this pack, really significantly challenging Haas the Boss, but she manages to get through, and she is your lead jammer for the first time in this game. Texas in control of that clock.
All right, Haas the Boss is going to come around for that scoring pass. Meanwhile, Lady Trample is standing in the 888 penalty box. Haas the Boss looking for the outside line, going to get some offensive assistance, but now passive offense as Texas stops in the apex, trying to force Victorian to draw that bridge out. But now, seeing that it's not really working out too great, Texas going to try and have to squeeze up. But Lady Trample has returned to the pack, so penalty kill on behalf of Victoria. Lady Trample now trying to make that pass as she's going to have to go through the Texas defense all over again. Getting some assistance from number 10 Biceptual, was unable to open the inside line. Lady Trample now recycling on that outside.
She's also removed the helmet cover from her helmet and does a star stash to get through. She did have to repeat that initial pass, so no points on that pass. But Lady Trample now on a scoring pass. Haas the Boss acutely aware and calling off the jam. And if you would like to skate like these fantastic players out here, we'd love for you to go visit Adam Skates. Savant Wheels by Adam. Light, fast, responsive, everything you look for in a wheel. Now let's check out this replay. There we see that's that track, we saw a foot go out of bounds for Lady Trample, but she jumps on through. And Haas the Boss shoved to the infield, forced to recycle. I think that was right where we saw Lady Trample head to the 888 penalty box.
And here we see Christy Demons again, jamming for Victoria, Gravy Baby for Texas. Gravy Baby trapped behind that brace three wall. And then in the front, Christy Demons trying to push through, moving laterally, and is going to just power her way through. Lead jammer going to Christy Demons and Victoria. Gravy Baby, oh, no, we do have a star pass confirmed. It was pretty sneaky. Smarty Pants now jamming for Texas.
So some pretty nice offensive assistance there by Polygon once that jammer was gone. Now, this is something we've seen Victoria do time and time again, where they basically form a wrecking ball and pull the entire pack over to one far side of that track and try and make space for their jammer. Now that they're spread out, we've got that bridge, which we've seen a lot of teams do, but Smarty Pants picking them off one by one. Pack now spread out over about the course of 40, 50 feet.
And Smarty Pants, one blocker left to go, using her hips and her thighs to just move that blocker further and further, and they are going to have to let her go. So much work goes into drawing that bridge out. So we're going to see Christy Demons now calling the jam off as Smarty Pants puts that pressure on. Christy Demons putting up. Looks like it's going to be 3 points on the board for Victoria. Texas keeping the game within a six-point spread as we are now at 19 minutes and 20 seconds going into jam number 8 of period 1 of this game. In this replay, we're going to see Christy Demons get trapped there in the back, but up at the front, it's going to be Smarty Pants doing work. See her put her hips and her shoulder just right into the gut of Victoria's blockers, forcing them to drop off and behind. Ivy Knivey now jamming for Victoria. Freight Train for Texas. Freight Train moving just right straight up the middle in a typical Freight Train style, and Victoria a little bit flustered by it, unable to get together, but now they've managed to reform. on the outside. We've got Ivy Knivy looking to find that line just little bits at a time. Freight Train taking advantage of that space and now pushing Victorian blockers out front. Two blockers left to go. Oh, and now the full complement has recycled up, but they did have to drop Danny Darko in order to maintain that pack. So now Freight Train leaning heavy at the front. Ivy Knivy still trying to fight against Texas's scrummy blockers in the back.
Danny Darko pulling out of that Victorian defensive formation to go provide some offensive assistance, and that's something that Victorian does a lot more than Texas. Texas tends to leave their jammers to fend for themselves, and Freight Train is a very capable, very able blocker, but this Victorian defense is something else.
It certainly is. Ivy Knivy getting able to get through on that apex with after hitting, pulling back, and then just kind of sliding in with very little resistance to complete that initial pass, is now on a scoring pass. A collapse and a big hit in the apex, but we were focused a little bit on Texas, where we do see a completed star pass to Trauma. Trauma now having the star for Texas. Ivy Knivy pushed to the outside and will call the jam off before Trauma is able to make that apex jump. 2 points on the board for Victoria.
Now, something we got to note here. Look at this. This is how tight and how tense all of these jams have been. Beautiful hit there by Texas's number 27, Peace War. Beautiful jammer takeout right in the apex, and every single point has been working that hard. It is no small feat for Victoria to earn each of those points. Texas as well.
Sarah Chambers going to be on the jam line. So first time out for her in this game. Haas the Boss wearing the star for Texas. Haas forced to recycle on the inside. She'll move back around to the back with the brace tripod. Sarah Chambers now at front on the outside and blown up.
I think that's an appropriate adjective right there. Blown up.
By Stoner. So she will recycle all the way back around. Sarah Chambers now... trying to find the same inside middle line that Haas the Boss was looking for. Maybe getting both jammers, though, as soon as they make a little headway, they're kind of getting squeezed back out.
And here we go. Here's that wrecking ball formation. Once again, Victoria taking and wrapping themselves around the entire Texas defense and shoving all of them out to that outside, jammers and all, including theirs.
And now we're going to see that tripod in the back holding Haas back as Sarah Chambers able to finally bridge out Texas's blockers to get her out. So Sarah Chambers now lead jammer for Victoria on a scoring pass now and skips through on the inside line by the width of a skate. 5 in the sky for Victoria.
I got to say, Sarah Chambers, one thing we see from her is she basically dances through that pack. Lots of little tight turns, and that seems to be her trick to get through those tiny tight spaces.
So that agile jammer can definitely make use of the smallest space. We do have, it looks like, a star pass. It is going to be to Stoner. Stoner now jammer for Texas. Stoner being forced out and will recycle back behind the jammer line. Sarah Chambers recycling in the center of the straightaway. So this pack this go-round seems to have been a lot more condensed. Is that Texas learning and Texas kind of taking a page maybe out of Victoria's book?
It very well may be. And look at this, Haas the Boss going on the defensive, taking out Sarah Chambers. But she just knocked her down. She didn't knock her out of bounds. So Sarah had to kind of regroup for a second there, thinking that she needed to recycle, but she stayed in bounds. And we have that trio of Texas blockers knocking Sarah down. She was splayed out on the track like I haven't seen a Victoria jammer do in quite some time. So now, you guys, check out this replay we've got here. So in the corner, this is where we see that trio of blockers this is the spin move where she got lead jammer status. So again, that really tight turn to the inside line, getting past those three blockers right in the apex. And it's a game of inches at this point.
We are going to have an official timeout. It looks like an official review is being called, and Victoria may be the one responsible for that. Sarilson was out in the middle of the track rather quickly. And we are going to, looks like, attribute that to Victoria, that official timeout brought to us by Roller Derby Elite.
So we're going to look at right here on this replay, this Roller Derby Elite replay. We see Haas the Boss taking herself out as she takes out Sarah Chambers right there in turn one. And then an immediate regroup there by a tag team of Texas blockers trying to hold her back, and does so relatively effectively. Victoria coming out of that last jam 9-3. Score is currently 32-18 as we head into jam number 10.
And we have Laddie.
Victorian would like a embellishment call assessed on the white jammer.
Looking for embellishment on Haas the Boss. Of course, we would have to be in there to kind of get the context of what specific parts they're looking for to apply embellishment to for Haas the Boss. So we will wait while the officials conglomerate and have a discussion. In the meantime, Scarlett, we have some amazing supporters for the WFTDA playoff tournament circuit.
That indeed we do. Of course, this timeout brought to you by Roller Derby Elite. Roller Derby Elite wants you to experience skating at warp speed. They're the skates you need when you are ready to level up your game. Check out rollerderby-elite.com. And I've just been notified by our producer that the embellishment clarification is that they're wanting a call regarding faking impact, so a flop, if you will, in other sports. So that's what we're looking for, or that's what Victorian is looking for, a call on. I believe that was probably on that hit that Haas the Boss made.
Yes, yeah, definitely that's kind of what we're talking about when we're thinking about embellishment. But was it specifically that action? Since, you know, it was featured, you know, we all got to kind of see it. But, you know, for any, you know, point of reference, it could have been, you know, something else that she did somewhere else on the track. But Laddie will clarify.
After further review, an embellishment call will be made on the Texas Jammer 5-5. Victoria's review will be retained.
Retained official
there
review.
There you have it, an embellishment.
Apparently, this weekend is the weekend for retained official reviews.
Anything can happen at playoffs. Anything can happen in Dallas. And we have a very well-trained officiating staff. So, Victoria, again, masterful management of not only the clock, but officials and of the rules. I think they know this. They know the rule book, and they know the clock like the back of their hand, and shows here as they pull that official review very strategically. We are now going into minute 3. All right, so here we go. This is number... This is Sarah trying to get through on the inside.
This is, I think what we're seeing. So Haas forced to the inside, and will assumptively recycle. But
I'm not sure if that's where the embellishment happened. But either way, the bottom line is that Haas the Boss is going to. Okay, here we go. So. Sarah Chambers sneaking on through.
Oh, maybe it was that hop.
Oh.
So that, you know, being on the track and being all the way over here, it's definitely a little different. So thank you, replay. As we move on in roller derby with that embellishment call being assessed, I think that's the first one I've ever seen. Lady Trample now out first, lead jammer.
On a power jam, no less.
On a power jam as a...
Stoneher is who they have listed, who is sitting in the 888 penalty box.
Ah, so it happened after the star pass.
Right.
There we go.
Right.
So that makes a lot more sense. So Stoneher taking a seat in the penalty box after having received the star. So we'll begin this jam as jammer once released from the 888 penalty box. Lady Trample now on the outside, completing a scoring pass, putting 5 points on the board for Victoria, extending their lead 37-18, as Stoneher has been released now and is fighting to make that initial pass in the top of the apex.
And we have two very different defensive formations. Texas with a four-woman wall across that track, and Victoria with a three-blocker formation in the front, tripod defense. And Victoria currently skating short because they have one blocker, Yana Nuku, in the penalty box. That 888 penalty box seems to be getting popular here as we head into jam number 11. Speaking of 888, they have helmets, pass, wrist guards, and they've got you covered protecting derby since day one. Go visit 888.com. And it looks like we do have a team timeout on the track, and that timeout is brought to you, of course, by Roller Derby Elite, the skates for when you are ready to level up your game. Check out rollerderby-elite.com. And, you know, Shady, these teams are both playing for that next step towards the Hydra, right? So one thing we'd love for everyone to do is go visit WFTDA.tv, go get your watch pass. You can still purchase it. You want to see not only Victoria and Texas and all of these other wonderful teams that are going to be at the championship tournament.
Minnesota, our tribal.
Absolutely. And we know that you want to see all the action, and we want you to see your brackets, too. So we'd love for you to go fill out a championship bracket. Who do you think is going to take home the Hydra? Now, check out this replay we see right here. This is Lady Trample with that signature move getting held back by those three Texas blockers. Looks like we had an edge
just barely
of a wheel, but it stayed in bounds. So
on is in.
We have
Ivy Knivey wearing the star for Victoria, and that's going to be Freight Train again for Texas. Freight Train coming out with an impunity. Freight Train on the line after a clock stoppage. So Freight Train with a pivot around the inside. It's going to be Freight Train earning lead jammer for Texas.
That is their second lead jam so far in this game, and that's been this is the first jam that they've had lead jammer with the other jammer on the track.
So I believe so as well, as we had the first scoring pass for Freight Train. 5 points up in the sky for Texas. Freight Train
living up to her namesake right there.
So as per as per usual, Freight Train coming hitting the back of the pack with impunity, trying to find that line and just surge forward. We do have an opening for Ivy Knivey. Ivy Knivey completing that initial pass. And Freight Train going to go ahead and call the jam off. Looks like just in time, holding Victoria scoreless. Another 2 points for Texas. 7 point jam just then for Texas as we hit the 12 minute, 30 second mark going into jam number 12.
So here's a replay. That's where we see Freight Train get through and grab that lead jammer status. Now, one thing we saw toward the end of that jam. Oh, hello, back block on your own blocker. But hey, if you got to use them for, as a wrecking ball, you do it. Look at that takeout right there by Stoner. And a follow-up. Man, that's something that Texas is doing really, really well right now, is that initial hit and then the follow-up with the tag team, which seems to be sending out those Victoria blockers.
That was a Smarty Pants follow-up. Christy Demon's now going to wear the star for Victoria. Olivia Shooten John for Texas. We haven't seen OJ in a few jams, so wondering if there's a particular reason for that, for them to change their lineup. But OJ now with two blockers left to go out front.
Lots of edging and lots of C-shaped movements that we're seeing OJ use, and that's something we do see her do, but typically fast feet and a little bit different movement. And then we've got Christy Demons with a leap to the inside. She manages to jump through and grab lead jammer status for Victoria.
So we are going to have lateral movement where Peace War is pulled down with Christy Demons. Maybe not necessarily pulled might be the wrong word, but just kind of fell along that same line. So it's kind of a domino effect. Olivia Shooten John removing the cover from her helmet will recycle back into turn number one. Olivia Shooten John looking for that first lane, but is swung out by the Victorian tripod. Peace War now drawing Christy Demons back into that turn number one, and the pack glomming up into this little amoeba of blue and white as Christy Demons is pushed onto the track, onto the ground, will recycle. Just not 100% sure if it was only one hand, one arm, so we're gonna be safe anyway. Star pass now on behalf of Texas to Trauma. And Christy Demons will shut that down right away.
So something that we saw on this jam, you know, earlier you mentioned Texas kind of learning and adapting and taking a page out of another team, out of Victoria's book. So here we have Christy Demons and that conglomeration there at turn two. Now, it looked like that was kind of incidental contact, players getting squeezed, and Christy Demons unfortunately taking a fall there. But one thing we're seeing Texas do is they're starting to do that wraparound pack. And that's something Victoria does really well, and that seemed to serve them very well here in this last jam.
Sarah Chambers now wearing the star for Victoria, Haas the boss for Texas. Victoria holding a 20-point lead over Texas, 45-25, just under 10 minutes left. We do have a multiplayer penalty being issued to a blocker from Texas. We'll confirm that, and that's going to be...
This is Sarah Chambers. Is this only her second jam?
It is only Sarah Chambers' second jam. A multiplayer now being dropped.
Oh, that's on Bone Shaker.
Mm-hmm. Bone Shaker picking up a multiplayer block as they take a seat in the 888 penalty box. Sarah Chambers still held back by that Texas tripod in the back, and that is Screw Barrymore trying to run communication from the front of the pack to the back of the pack as Haas the boss pushing past, forcing those two Victoria blockers out of play. Lead jammer going to Texas, but just as it happens, Sarah Chambers able to take advantage of that lead call and that forced reformation of the pack and was able to pop out as well.
Now look at this. We saw the pack get really spread out when Haas grabbed lead jammer status, and that was how she was able to get it. But it didn't really reform at all. So we saw a very loose conglomeration, a very loose tripod of Victoria form right there at the very end as Haas snuck through. But we also saw Sarah Chambers sneak by on that one for 5 points. And I think it was because everyone was so spread out. Both jammers could just zigzag their way right through. Victoria coming out of that one with 5 points. Texas with two. Score is currently 46-27. 8.5 minutes left in the first half.
Gravy Baby going to jam for Texas. Lady Trample for Victoria. Lady Trample looking to use those legs and you're looking to use her toe stops to establish position on the track, which she does. Anywhere she puts those toe stops, she has claimed that space and is going to use it for whatever purpose she sees fit. Lead jammer now for Victoria.
She dodged a swing and a miss on that first pass by CeCe Boom, who follows up and actually takes her out there in the straightaway right after the jam line.
So we do have Gravy Baby able to complete the initial pass. Penalty, I believe failure to return, dropped to Victoria to help Gravy Baby escape. Lady Trample going to call that jam off. 3 points for Victoria. Victoria kind of mastering the get your points and call it right now. And I think that's really how you have to handle a team like Texas. They don't seem to be underestimating them at all. Mm-hmm. They are giving them credit where credit is due.
Absolutely.
And they are definitely being respectful of their opponent.
Absolutely. And you see that, too. We're seeing a little bit more risky play than we've seen in this weekend so far. We've seen a handful of players go to the box, and with Victoria's other games, you didn't see that until much later on in the game. So, people, it's all or nothing here with a beautiful hit there, and that follow-up by Texas didn't take the hit all the way to the line like we mentioned before, but those follow-ups at least burn a little bit of time off the clock and hold back Ivy Knivey, who's now your lead jammer for Victoria.
That hit being credited to Polygon. So Polygon, if maybe had just skated an extra foot, would have just blown Ivy Knivey to the outside at the top of the apex. Ivy Knivey now on a scoring pass as number 20, Laura Evans, comes in from the 888 penalty box, rather, back to the track. Freight Train now leaning for Texas at the back of the brace tripod. Ivy Knivey coming in and hitting the pack and just moving those Texas blockers out. But it seemed to be with Sarrelson's offensive assistance, there just wasn't a lot to it. Star pass now by Texas to Smarty Pants. Smarty
Very
Pants.
Sneaky pass.
It was this whole weekend
so sneaky.
Has been like just like, I mean, not that they're supposed to be obvious. I mean, it's a star pass. You don't want it to be like, here, guys, I'm handing the star. But these are particularly well-placed and well-designed star passes this weekend.
But it doesn't seem to fool Victorian at all as they immediately mass up around Smarty Pants and just abandon Freight Train to the back. And all of the confusion there manages to give Ivy Knivey a beautiful opening. So she sneaks right on through for another grand slam. 15 points so far for Ivy Knivey.
That was a really interesting thing that just happened. So Smarty Pants was exiting the pack and passed right by Sarrelson, and Sarrelson saw Smarty Pants and just wasn't even concerned.
This is that hit that we were talking about in the apex. Beautiful work being done there by Polygon with a follow-up there from, and then we see her get right back up. Oh, it looks like we may have had a face hit for Texas there.
So a high block being assessed to Smarty Pants in that last jam. So now we're going to have Christy Demons for Victoria and Olivia Shootin' John for Texas.
That was actually Stoneher that took the penalty and is now sitting in the 888 penalty box.
I see. And we've got Christy Demons out first in lane three on the outside. Lead jammer for Victoria, Olivia Shootin' John taking advantage of the pack being broken up in the top of the apex.
Look how solid that Victoria tripod is up in the front. We have a very clearly split defensive formation here. We've got Texas in a box formation in the back of the pack at turn two, and Victoria keeping that tight tripod using all three of their blockers to shove OJ out of bounds. And we do have a star pass. It's going to go to Trauma. She's going to now take over point scoring duties for Texas.
Christy Demons calling it off, not allowing Trauma to get those points, but not before taking a lovely shoulder contact.
And here we have the replay. And that's the star pass that we saw right there from OJ to Trauma. And it was seamless and everybody's backs were turned. So great placement there. Then we see a hit
to Peace War.
But no penalties assessed. And we want you guys to go check out Ona Treats, onatreats.com. Yum Butter and Ona are fueling our athletes, volunteers, and staff all weekend.
That's some delicious, delicious snacks as Lady Trample finds a delicious inside line. Lead Jammer. I tried to segue that. I'm sorry. I apologize. Trample, though, coming around on your screen just about now for a scoring pass. Meanwhile, Haas the Boss trapped by the Victorian tripod. They're trying to waterfall her out to the inside. Texas quickly switching to offense as Lady Trample is having to recycle all the way back around, but has received a backblock penalty, was not recycling. Receiving a backblock penalty, Haas the Boss removing the star cover. Now one blocker left to go. That's Biceptual, and Biceptual is going to have to let her go. So we are going to have a two-minute jam.
What a shame Haas took that helmet cover off because there was no lead jammer awarded yet. So, but either way, we're going to have 2 minutes for Texas to try and pick up some points. But look at this speed. Victoria speeding things up pretty significantly, trying to make it more difficult for Haas to get through.
So Haas being knocked down in the back by a bone shaker. And now Biceptual pushing Haas the Boss to the outside. We'll have to kill time by recycling back into turn number one. Lady Trample following along behind. And the whole pack, we're just going to move right back to where we started, guys.
Rewind. And let's do it all over again. And we've got Texas in a four-wall, a very loose four-wall, I should say, across the track. And they were so loosely defined, in fact, that Lady Trample was able to easily find some space to get through and grabs 4 points on her first scoring pass.
Jackie Daniels trying to hunt her down, but just ran out of space to do it. And Lady Trample now re-entered the pack in order to make a scoring pass. A pivot on the inside line laterally moves to turn lane number two. Through turn number two, now we're going to see a score from Lady Trample. Full 5 points for Victoria. And we are seeing Haas trying to find the inside, having removed the helmet cover, will recycle, and now re-donning the helmet cover, I guess deciding against anything. And that hit in that shoulder.
You know, what? One thing that is standing out to me is the big smiles that we are seeing on all of these players' faces. Like Lady Trample just there got knocked down rather hard and had the biggest grin on her face. So here we see that signature Lady Trample C-shape that she does where she leans her torso out pretty far and then swings her legs around the other side. Nice juke there right past number seven, Jackie Daniels. For Lady Trample and added to that 11 points total she grabbed on that last jam.
We are going to have Freight Train and Ivy Knivey jamming now for their respective teams. Peace War fought to find that front of the pack position, but Ivy Knivey taking advantage and able to move around. Freight Train saving herself, having to pivot on the outside, was able to make it through on a scoring pass, but Ivy Knivey will call it off. And 0 points for Texas, but one additional point for Victoria. And I want to take a minute to answer one of your questions on Twitter as we are sitting just under a minute to finish this period out. We do have some folks that are questioning what the red circles are on several of the players.
We'll come back to that, but let's check out this replay. Freight Train with a spin move at turn two and then a juke past that last Victoria blocker. And that's how she was able to grab a couple points there. We do have an official timeout on the track brought to you by Roller Derby Elite. They want you to experience skating at warp speed. RollerDerby-Elite.com. Now we can talk about the round circles on everyone's backs.
Well, first I'd like to talk about the fact that the official timeout just now has resulted in an additional point for Victoria. But in light of those red circles, we do have several massage therapists in the building today, and I do know several of the players were partaking in some cupping. So cupping, a technique where the skin is sucked up and separated from kind of the under layers underneath, and it can help improve range of motion, things like that. So I do know several of the players really found that to be helpful for them. Sarah Chambers now out lead jammer first for Victoria at the beginning of this jam. We're in jam number 19 of period one. Period clock now less than 30 seconds to go. Olivia Shootin' John making a star pass to Smarty Pants. Smarty Pants able to exit the pack. And jam going to get called off before anything can be done by Smarty Pants. Timeout now on the track. Not 100% sure who called that timeout. I know it says official timeout on the track, but oftentimes in this situation, it could also be a team timeout.
So one thing that we are noticing is how effective Texas is when they have a power jam.
Okay, so it is going to be an official timeout. It looks like they're going to have to do some clarification and maintenance with scoring, potentially the scoreboard.
So speaking of scoreboard, one thing that we've noticed is that Texas is really, really effective on those power jams. Somehow they're able to combat that Victoria defense much more effectively whenever they have more people in the pack to help out and provide that offensive assistance. Now you're looking at the penalties. Let's see how that's impacting things. I'm surprised to see so many Victoria players that have already gone to the box, because in their previous game we've seen at this tournament, we really didn't see that this early on. Texas still sitting pretty comfortably with only a handful of players, with a handful of penalties. Nobody in danger of fouling out by any means. But I think both teams know what's on the line here, so they're taking a lot of risks. And
it really is intriguing to me that at this stage that the 888 penalty box has seen more visits by Victorian roller derby than it has by the Texas Roller Girls.
Absolutely. And now if you look at the scoring, we see right here Lady Trample in a commanding lead with 28 points for the Victorian Roller Derby League. And Ivy Knivey not far behind with 26, Christy Demons with 22, and Sarah Chambers with 14. Haas the Boss leading Texas with 12, OJ with 10, Freight Train with 7, Stoner with 3, and Gravy Baby has yet to put points on the board, but we've seen her in a couple of really critical star passes that have led to some points, and it looks like we are heading into halftime.
We certainly are, so it looks like neither team was going to decide once they did make that adjustment for off of the official timeout that neither team was going to use any sort of clock stoppage, so we are going to go ahead and head into halftime. So we're going to do a little bit more conversation and maybe read through some of your questions, and we will be back with you after halftime here at the 2017 WFTDA International Division I Playoffs in Dallas. We'll see you back here in a minute. And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to period two of the final game of day three of the 2017 WFTDA International Division I Playoffs here in Dallas, Texas. I'm Shady Hawkins again, joined by Scarlett O'Hercha, and we are going to talk to you a little bit about what kind of went on in the first period, and what we're maybe not necessarily hoping, but what we're thinking we're going to see going forward. So, Scarlett, when Texas stepped onto the track, we were really taking a look at their defense and seeing like what they were going to do to try and manage these jammers. So where are we at right now? Like as a skater, like as if you're Texas, what are you doing?
Well, let's talk about those stats, and then maybe we can provide some insight there. So jammer penalties were really kind of impacting VRDL a little bit in the first half. Texas with one jammer penalty, Victoria with three, and lead jammer status is really what we saw the difference in. And if you look at these point totals, you can see how that factored in. So Lady Trample with six jams out of our first portion and two trips to the box. So two of those jammer penalties on Lady Trample, the top point scorer with 28 points. Ivy Knivey following with 26. And then on Texas's side, we've got Haas the Boss ahead with 12 and Olivia Shootin-Jod with 10. Now, both of those, the 10 points that we're seeing from OJ there came in one power jam. And the power jams are really the story of how Texas has gotten to where they are right now in terms of points. Texas had 20 points on power jams, but without a power jam, when you've got the other jammer in the pack, they're only at 12. So we've got to keep... Or what Texas wants to do right now is try to put Victoria's jammer in the box a little bit more so they have that power jam opportunity. And lead jammer went to Victoria 15 times in the first half. Texas only grabbed it three. So I think that's been pretty critical in the fact that we're at a 90-32 score right now heading into the second half.
So as being Texas blockers, they're clearly more effective at putting a jammer in the box than Victorian defense is being right now. Victorian only putting a jammer penalty on one jammer for Texas. So if you're Texas, you find a way to do that more. So, and we are going to start this game off with Freight Train, and that is Christy Demons wearing the star for Victoria. Christy Demons forced to recycle back into the straightaway, and now finding that inside line on the toe stops, but doesn't quite make it past Smarty Pants. Smarty Pants pushing Christy Demons into the inside. Freight Train now fighting against that brace three wall, but getting some assistance from Peace War. Will have to recycle back in also. So Victoria trying to draw back and pull the penalty, but wasn't able to do so. Christy Demons now finally finding that inside line. Lead jammer going to Victoria.
Now, that took about 30 seconds for Christy Demons to get that lead jammer status, and that's not typical of Victoria. They typically jump out and get that right away, and we do have a star pass, another really sneaky one there as Freight Train hands over the helmet cover to Smarty Pants, but before Smarty can even get it on her helmet, the jam is called. And Victorian puts 4 points on the board. Now, that's a story we've seen here in the first half where Victoria getting those small scoring jams. We really haven't seen any big blowout jams thus far. Look at this triangle, this tripod we've got right here holding back Freight Train. And then Peace War running in and trying to break up that tripod, but not successful there because Victoria's not moving. They were absolutely stuck to that floor.
There was a little bit of a breakup, but the quickness with which that they had to completely just honestly shift the whole structure over to the side. Sarah Chambers now jamming and lead jammer for Victoria. Olivia Shootin-John leading for Texas, or jamming for Texas rather. Olivia Shootin-John removing the helmet cover, and it looks like we are going to have a star pass. They just cut off the camera, but Trauma did receive the star and is jamming.
Sarah Chambers shoved to the outside of the track with a follow-through hit by that tripod of Texas defenders. And we would love for you guys to go check out Bont. The Athena plates are lightweight aluminum, 20-degree plates. You can come take a look at bont.com. Score is currently 97-32. Victoria in the lead as we head into jam number three of the second half.
Freight Train again as we're going into jam number three for Texas, and it's going to be Lady Trample.
Scrum start right off that line. Very mixed pack and very fast pack. Quickly jutting up to that pivot line into turn one. And speaking of turns, Freight Train manages to get through with a turn and a spin and a little bit of a shuffle. She's your lead jammer for Texas.
Lady Trample now removing the star from her helmet as she barrels into the center of Texas's wall and just hops over Polygon of Texas and is able to complete the initial pass. Freight Train now being gummed up on the outside line, but saves it on the toe stops. Really wants to complete this pass. Lady Trample is entered in and passed at least one blocker into this pack. So Freight Train definitely going to want to strategically complete this pass in order to not give up any point differential.
And she's trying. She was pushing that tripod of Victoria blockers pretty intensely, and Freight Train has some power behind her, but Victoria managing to shove her to the infield, and she's forced to regroup back a little bit further, and now Freight Train acutely aware of that, the fact that Lady Trample has gotten through the pack and is now on her scoring pass. She really was looking for her, but wanted to try and get through and make some of those points, so she waits a little bit to call off that jam. I think that's sort of taking a little bit of a page out of Victoria's book because their clock management is stellar.
Indeed. Texas with the Freight Train putting 5 points up on the board. That jam outscoring Victoria by one. Victoria now crossing the century mark, 101 to Texas's 37, as we are almost 4 minutes gone already in this period. Number two, jam number four incoming, as we have Ivy Knivey wearing the star for Victoria and Haas the Boss wearing the star for Texas. Ivy Knivey finds an inside line, is going to be determined lead jammer, but Texas not happy about that. They were pretty sure that they knocked her out to that outside line.
Yeah, we didn't see the line view here, so we can't confirm that. However, look at this box formation. We've got Victoria in that box up in the front trying to hold back Haas the Boss, and despite an offensive assist for Texas by the pivot Trauma, looks like we have a cutting the track penalty going to be called on Haas the Boss. So power jam for Victoria.
Power jam for Victoria as Haas the Boss. One skate went out in turn number one, so that's what the outside pack referee did see. So Ivy Knivey going to take advantage of that, going to call it off, and Victoria going to give us a power start.
Now, speaking of cutting the track penalties, we had someone on Twitter using the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA, and here we go. Let's look at this. This is her getting lead jammer status. Stays in bounds oh so barely with those toe stops. Oh, looks like we have a wheel on the outside of the line, just barely?
Maybe, with the angle of this camera, so it
can cheat it a little bit. If it's not overhead, you don't get, you know, the exact view.
Exactly. You could go either way, and it looks like Texas is going to go ahead and call a official review, and they may be reviewing this very, very motion, and that official review brought to us by Roller Derby Elite.
You can check them out at rollerderby-elite.com. Roller Derby Elite, experience skating at work.
Texas would like to review the lack of a cutting call assessed at the beginning of the jam on the blue jammer's zero.
Indeed. So that is what we are going to be looking at. And, as someone who has formerly been an official as well, that's what I'd be looking at for sure.
Well, and I think that Texas's position now change has also been helpful in them seeing it.
Here we are right now. We're going to see that, and it looks, man, that's super close. And it looked almost like, and here we're going to get a little bit of backwards, did that wheel touch? And it almost looks like it could, but is it the reflection of the wheel on the concrete, or did the wheel actually make contact outside?
The because toe stop was inbounds.
The toe stop is on the line, so it is considered inbounds, mm-hmm. But was that wheel actually on the outside? And mm-hmm. in that split second of a moment, with how fast her feet were moving, could an official really for sure say that it was out?
Well, either way, we're going to find out here very shortly as we've got our officials conferring in the middle of the track trying to evaluate that. And we would love for you guys to go take a very close look at some of the initiatives we have going on at the WFTDA, including the We Believe initiative in support of UN women. So we're going to tell you a little bit more about that as we come along in this game. But it looks like the officials are about ready to wrap up that official review and share with us what the verdict was. Again, we're seeing some smiles all around, and somebody on Twitter said, you know, Victoria didn't come all this way halfway around the world to not have fun. I think the officials may have too.
The Victorian jammer was not observed to go out of bounds during that initial pass. No cutting call will be assessed. The review will not be retained.
So upon a review, the officials determined that there was no touching to that outside line, and we will have a lost official review. Definitely something worthy of an official review. I know sometimes we can call official reviews for strategic regions to, you know, give us maybe a little bit of a longer timeout, but definitely something worthy to discuss. But again, in that amount of speed, could you really make a definitive call? Christy Demons now jamming for Victoria as we move forward with jam number 5. Lead jammer also going to Christy Demons. Haas the Boss now standing in the 888 penalty box as this was a power start for Victoria. Haas the Boss receiving a track cut penalty prior.
Very scattered pack in that first pass that Christy Demons made. We had a very mixed bag of defenders and offensive help from both teams, but now they have clearly formed two segmented defensive formations, and Christy Demons takes full advantage of that, grabbing 10 points thus far in the jam.
And now we do have a confirmed star pass. That's going to be Smarty Pants grabbing that star for Texas.
And it did look like Christy Demons may have collided with Haas there.
Christy Demons looking over to Haas the Boss to check on her before being removed from the track. Haas the Boss being picked up by her teammates from Texas. Looked like potentially that was called off for injury. Medics now checking on Haas the Boss as she comes over to her bench, holding her eye just a tad. And here's where we're going to see that impact. Christy Demons going over Haas the Boss and also coming down. And it looks like Christy did not call that off, so it was potentially called for injury.
Back to the action on the track. We've got Sarah Chambers jamming for Victoria and Freight Train jamming for Texas.
Sarah Chambers trying to push through the Texas defense. Freight Train moving through. Sarah Chambers taking advantage of a hole that Freight Train made on the inside and is going to take lead jammer position from Victoria.
And we do have Texas's pivot trauma heading to the 888 penalty box. Sarah Chambers with a spin move and a call-off while on her knees and sliding around that turn. She grabs 4 points and quickly calls it off. Score is currently 123-37, 23.5 minutes left in the game. And as we mentioned earlier, We Believe is one of the initiatives that the WFTDA is proud to support. And we are doing this with our charitable giving platform, We Believe. You can find out how to get involved and snag yourself exclusive merchandise at wftda.com/donate.
Indeed, I'm pretty sure there's a super cool t-shirt that we can get from that. Lady Trample, though, earning lead jammer currently as we are now underway, jam number 7. Lady Trample approaching the pack, as you see at the bottom of your screen, hitting that Texas tripod and perfect footing just then to pivot around that tripod and continue on her pass. Olivia Shooten-John backing up a little bit and getting a little bit of momentum before now entering the pack and getting some offensive assistance. Texas leaving two blockers in the back to face off Lady Trample, but just not enough. Smarty Pants and Asia Gare, captain for Texas, not able to form that two wall quick enough, and now we're going to see again another star pass on behalf of Texas to Trauma. So Lady Trample hitting the back of the pack, trauma. Approaching the pack is checked by Bisexual to the inside and will be forced to recycle back as Victorian bridges backwards and forms that tripod, sinks just right into that formation.
See, in that pack awareness that Victoria has, they're really quick to react to the shifting formations that they need to in order to respond to that jammer position. We've got Lady Trample being shoved out of bounds there at turn four, but it looks like we're going to have one of the blockers from Texas serve a penalty for that hit. Lady Trample does recycle, though, coming back to turn three and takes a hard hit right there by number 22, Polygon. And both teams regrouping and spreading out quite far, I'd say about 40 feet across the track, as Lady Trample with another spin move, but shoved to the infield there by Olivia Shootin-John.
Lady Trample now remaking this pass. So Olivia Shootin-John now just shoulder check with that aggressive, angry shoulder to the inside. Lady Trample looking at her bench going, what are you saying to me? I'm all the way over here. Let me finish. So Lady Trample now.
She's thinking about it.
She's thinking about it, and she's just going to go ahead and do it. Going to go ahead and call that off. Victoria with a 19-point jam, and Texas going to put up, just making sure, with the official holding a hand up, and boom, right into Polygon. And she's like, wow.
That kind of hurt, but I'm going to keep going with a smile.
Yep.
So Lady Trample, very able to stay steady with those hard hits and resist it, and that's why she is their top point scorer right now. Meanwhile, Gravy Baby jamming for Texas, but your lead jammer is Ivy Knivey.
Ivy Knivey just now getting out between lanes 3 and 4 on the outside. We'll come around on the bottom of your screen here in just a moment for that scoring pass. Gravy Baby completing her initial and getting out of the pack. Ivy Knivey with a few seconds left to try and get that last minute point, and is going to score as soon as the officials check with their OPRs. Just to confirm, it is going to be 3 points on that pass.
And we want to encourage you all to tweet us at WFTDA Live is where you can find our live tweets from the playoffs and championships. And you can talk directly to us with the hashtag #talk2WFTDA.
Right now, Sarah Chambers wearing the star for Victoria. And it's Freight Train on the inside line trying to find an opening, trying to make an opening. And that inside, that Freight Train had opened up but just was not able to get to. Sarah Chambers took advantage of lead jammer now for Victoria and Sarah Chambers as they hit 145 and Texas at 41.
And Freight Train is the only jammer for Texas who has been able to get lead jammer status here in the second half. So if there was a jammer who could be effective in shutting down the Victoria jammer, it would be Freight Train. But Sarah Chambers just so nimble, really jumping through that pack. I'm looking for an animal that would be an appropriate reference, but kind of like a gazelle, just leaping through. And we do have a star pass on the track, Shady.
That's Smarty Pants receiving the star yet again from Freight Train, now jamming for Texas. So coming out to the front, Sarah Chambers going to be almost stopped by Jackie Daniels, but Jackie Daniels did go out of play. We'll have to return to the pack. And now we're seeing a penalty drop to Freight Train. Freight Train going to receive a direction of gameplay penalty as Sarah Chambers puts an additional 5 points on the board for Victoria. Smarty Pants struggling behind the revolutionary tripod of Victoria in the apex. No pack occurring, so they are going to have to let Sarah Chambers go. And 5 more points as she completes that pass just before Smarty Pants gets there. 0 points for Smarty.
And by revolutionary, we do mean it's literally a revolving tripod that's turning and turning. And so here we see on that replay, Freight Train trying to make some space on the inside, just barely shoved with a foot to the infield, trying to make some space. But then we see Sarah Chambers with a lateral move from lane 3 over to lane 2, gets lead jammer status. This timeout by Texas brought to you by Roller Derby Elite, and you can check them out at rollerderby-elite.com. Roller Derby Elite wants you to experience skating at warp speed. And, you know, we've seen a lot of star passes out here tonight. I don't think we've seen any from Victoria, but Freight Train has been one of the lead star passers, and Texas has had 13 star passes thus far in this game. So here we see on that replay, that same shot we saw just a second ago, just from a slightly different angle, where Sarah Chambers really taking advantage of that lateral diagonal movement across that track, and Texas not able to pull up fast enough to reform that wall once they got past.
We're going to see, that's going to be Christy Demons wearing the star for Victoria, and Olivia Shootin-John OJ wearing the star for Texas.
Now the second half has been really critical for Victoria, widening that point spread. In the first half, Victoria had 90 points, Texas 32, and so far alone in the first few minutes of this second half, we've had 75 points for Victoria and 9 for Texas.
Lead jammer going to Christy Demons with an assist to pivot Danny Darko. Opening up a hole for Christy Demons, and Christy Demons taking advantage of the situation. Texas trying to waterfall Christy Demons out. She senses Olivia Shootin-John coming up and is going to call it off. 3 points on the board for Victoria, but they are still talking about it, looking at the OPRs, just confirming as far as hit passes, and it looks like that 3 points will stand.
So now that pack formation we saw is indicative of what Victoria's defense really does. That was like that wrecking ball conveyor belt type formation we've seen them do, where they just swarm around that Texas defense and shove everybody out to turn one.
Ivy Canivy for Victoria, Gravy Baby for Texas. Victoria sitting at 168, Texas at 41, as we are now in jam number 11 as we hit the 17-minute mark right about now.
Polygon with a jammer takeout there, forcing Ivy Canivy to recycle.
So Ivy Canivy looking for lane one, who's been kind of her friend the rest of the day, the entire day. So she's been able to take advantage of those tiny, tiny holes on the inside. So we've got, look, just the pile up in the back of the pack as Ivy Canivy pushes Stoner over. And then now Polygon forcing Ivy Canivy to the inside. Ivy Canivy now going to have to recycle all the way back behind all the Texas blockers. Moving from line to line, Ivy Canivy now... I mean, everything's just, everybody
it's
is
so
all
tight.
It's all
squished together. And I got to point out how Gravy Baby there for a bit was trying to get through that Victoria tripod by ducking down. And it wasn't really like a knee bend. She was almost folded in half at the waist, trying to sneak through those two back tripod blockers. Now we see a jammer takeout by Texas at the apex.
You know what, when these two walls get like really kind of garbled up together, and mm-hmm. you know, they're not a box, but they're not a tripod, but they're just this kind of thing. They kind of look like these like lumpy potatoes to me.
With specks of blue.
Yeah, the specks of blue lumpy potatoes.
Look at this Gravy Baby able to break up that Victoria tripod and pick off those blockers one by one, and grabs lead jammer status for Texas. Only the second time Texas has had lead jammer here in the second half.
So Gravy Baby, a very smooth transitional style of skater. And
we do have a blocker from Texas, that is Asia Gare, going to the 888 penalty box. And the pack has regrouped at turn three. And we have... we're heading into jam number 12 with 15 minutes left in the game, 168-43. Here's a replay of that instance where Gravy Baby was able to get lead jammer. She sneaks right on past that last Victoria blocker. Believe that was Blondage, number 128, and gives Texas their second lead jammer status. They come out with 2 points on that last jam.
Here we have Sarah Chambers now going to jam for Victoria, Freight Train for Texas. Sarah Chambers finding the inside, able to pivot around the smallest of holes, but its Freight Train is going to outrun Sarah Chambers and force that call off.
Freight Train now with 3 lead jam statuses throughout the game.
So that was Sarah Chambers with lead. It just so happened that as Sarah Chambers got lead, a Freight Train was able to burst out of the pack in that forward charging motion like she usually does and just overtook her. So since Freight Train was out front first, Sarah calling that off to stop Freight Train from outrunning her to the pack.
Then I correct my statement. Freight Train has had two lead jammer statuses. Haas has had two. And Gravy has had one for Texas thus far in the game.
Lady Trample on the outside, making it look easy. And it certainly
she really
is
does.
Not.
It is. We do have a star down on the track. It looks like it fell off of Olivia Schutenjohn's helmet, but she picks it back up and is now stashing it as she tries to get through that pack. Now look at Texas swarming Lady Trample and taking a page out of Victoria's book.
So, but with Victoria stretched out that way, going through the apex, they are going to have to drop blockers, and that's going to reduce their effectiveness against a nimble jammer like Lady Trample. Lady Trample going to go ahead and call the jam off as she
nice jammer takeout by Stoner that forced that call off by Lady Trample.
Indeed. It looked like she heard the whistle and wasn't sure. She's like, is it me? Is it not me? Well, anyway, the jammer's coming up, so let's call that off, so no points. Now we're going to see Freight Train going to take a stand on the line
here's
with
a
Chrissy Demons.
Here's a replay of that jammer takeout we're talking about, and that's that follow-through hit that Texas is nailing, and it's just at the right time. So Lady Trample getting shoved out by one of Texas's blockers and then immediately getting followed through with another hit.
All right, Freight Train looking for the outside, isn't unable to find it. One blocker down, well, it was one blocker down for each team. Now Victoria getting Sarrelson back on the track from the 888 penalty box.
Looks like we do have a 4-3 pack advantage for Texas.
Chrissy Demons looking a little confused right off the bat. Both Freight Train and Chrissy Demons coming out of the pack almost exactly at the same time. And Chrissy Demons was out first and did get called lead jammer, but there was that. And are you sure? Is it me? Okay, well, you're pointing at me, so going to call it off. So we'll see that again here. Freight Train finding the inside, and Chrissy Demons almost pushed a little bit by Freight Train. It was just kind of an incidental contact and momentum gathering. Freight Train nudging her aside, taking advantage of are you sure it's me? You're pointing at me? All right, let's do this.
I think she was also looking at her bench because Victoria's bench is just on it. And look at that. Literally 2 seconds is what it took for Sarah Chambers to get lead jammer status as she busted through on that inside line.
Gravy Baby seeing a little bit more play time this second period, wearing the star for Texas now. Sarah Chambers now trying – Texas – now forming a way more structured box formation and a rotationary movement in the top of those apex. Sarah Chambers having to fight to find those tiny little holes because all it takes is a hole the size of a toe stop and so, you can make it through.
So the camera isn't showing this right now, but on the other side of the track, like literally almost halfway across the track, we had Gravy Baby up at the front against that last Victoria blocker.
Gravy Baby not quite able to make it to the pack. Victoria, a master at knowing where that opposing jammer is, being very aware and very in tuned with their bench, making sure that they are calling that off with just the right amount of time.
We would love for you guys to go check out S1 Helmets. The S1 Lifer Helmet is best fit plus superior protection, and it is made for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer. You can add the S1 Lifer Visor Helmet for next level protection. Check
here
out
we see that,
S1Helmets.com.
Here we see that bridge all the way out in that replay, which we were talking about earlier. Victoria just marking that space. Ivy Knivey wearing the star now for Victoria. Olivia Schutenjohn for Texas. Olivia trapped back in turn number one as Ivy Knivey draws out the Texas bridge now to become lead jammer.
That was a lot of early confusion there. It seemed like Ivy got out in front really quickly, and Texas was just trying to keep up to stay in front of her and create that three wall. But they got a little loosely organized at the front, and Ivy was able to find some space to get through. It looks like Victoria is going to take 4 points on that pass.
It seems like Texas is maybe being a little bit more inconsistent with their blocker continuity. Like they'll go like two or three where they're just on it and dead, and they're able to like move, and they're able to flex, and they're able to bend, and they're able to kind of like absorb and cushion a blow and a hit. And then there are times in the pack where it just seems like the Victorian jammers just have their number, and they get them all spread out, and they get them kind of kerfuffled and separated. So.
Now we've got, speaking of kerfuffled and separated, these two jammers are trying to separate this pack so that they can break on through. Freight Train on the inside, Lady Trample on the outside, and Freight manages to get through, gets declared lead jammer. Had one hand on the inside, but she's trying to be safe rather than sorry. They don't need any more jammer penalties for Texas, so Lady Trample uses the confusion to call off, I mean, sorry, to make her way through that pack and around that track, and Freight with the awareness calls it off. So here we see that replay, Freight breaking on through, and no skates touching the inside, but that one hand went down and she just wasn't sure.
We can't be 100% sure that a skate did not touch the inside, because as she was passing through the apex, Sarilson was kind of like right there behind her, so mm-hmm. and it kind of obscured the view of the skates going through the apex until Freight Train went down. So maybe yes, maybe no, always better to be safe than sorry. Olivia Schutenjohn now for Texas. Christy Demons, as we are now in jam number 18 with 8 minutes and 46 seconds left to go in this second period of this championship game for Division I playoffs. Christy Demons, lead jammer now for Victoria, as Smarty Pants receiving the star yet again for Texas. Going to make her way through the apex and is able to escape the pack.
So one thing we saw on this jam was that really classic Victoria defensive formation. We had the triangle in the back holding back the opposing jammer, and then we had that one offensive assistive blocker up in the front trying to break up the other defensive formation so that their jammer can get through. Now, Texas has not really been providing a whole lot of offensive assistance for their jammers, and that seems to be pretty key for Victoria. If you look at how they're lining up on the line right now, we have all four Texas blockers spread out across in one line, and that one, we'll say, drifting Victoria blocker on that outside trying to clear some space for her jammer.
It's interesting that we're seeing a little bit more of a an older style blocking formation out of Texas to then be shifted into a more traditional style as Ivy Knivey is able to earn lead jammer on the outside, saving it on that very, very thin line, lane four. Gravy Baby for Texas, stuck at the front of the pack.
And this is the longest scoreless streak for Texas in this game so far. 7 jams without any points on the board, and Victoria's taking advantage of that 14-0 here in the last few jams.
So it really seems like Victoria, having played, you know, with the last time these teams met, really did their homework and really kind of modified like how they handle a team like Texas that typically is very defensively cohesive, but we're just not seeing that cohesion except with, you know, with Peace War, like kind of it's almost a little bit more of an individual game, Peace War, with a little bit of a tumble in the apex.
We're seeing little flashes of it. That's the thing. We'll see them come together, but then we're getting a lot of individualism out on the track, and looks like, okay, so right here, this is where we see them tag teaming and trying to get Ivy Knivey out of bounds, but then there's that distraction there by that other blocker. But Peace War, man, on the follow-up and the follow-through.
The Peace War's follow-up blocking today has been pretty on fire.
Yeah, so. Indeed.
So Peace War having a great game today. Sarah Chambers now wearing the star for Victoria, Freight Train for Texas. Sarah Chambers using her legs to really just stretch herself across the track. Freight Train bowling over in the front of Victoria in defense. So now Freight Train getting a little bit lower, but Victoria forcing Freight Train around to the inside. Polygon going to try to offer a little bit of offensive assistance, but really isn't able to do terribly much because Sarah Chambers is threatening that wall up at the front of the pack. Now Victoria able to drop a blocker. That's going to be Bone Shaker. Bone Shaker up at the front trying to assist Sarah Chambers in getting through the pack. They're going through it and really putting their shoulder into the middle of that Texas defense. And it looks like in the back now, Victoria settling into that tripod as Freight Train fighting to just move somebody out of position.
Yeah, so Bone Shaker actually started the jam in the 888 penalty box, but now that they're out of the box, they're able to provide that offensive assistance that their jammer seems to need. So Texas is shifting from doing that box formation that they had previously into that tripod that's braced, and having that floater that just goes toe-to-toe one-on-one with Bone Shaker. So neither jammer has emerged from the pack. We still don't have a lead jammer, and we only have 35 seconds left in this jam.
And now we're going to see a lead jammer finally. Freight Train earning lead jammer for Texas. Freight Train entering the pack now, looking for the outside line, is denied that outside line, will be drawn all the way back into the apex. And we have a forearm penalty now being assessed to Sarah Chambers. With that forearm, Freight Train now not only lead, but on the power jam for Texas.
This is Victoria's first jammer penalty of the half, and Texas going to try and capitalize on that Freight Train grabs 3 points before calling it off, and Texas will have a power start here in jam number 21. Now, for those of you that are watching us on the live stream, oh, we're going to look at this. Speaking of live stream, this is where you can see these instant replays we're talking about. We have a pile up here in the straightaway. Sarah Chambers on the back end of that pile up, and look at this follow through here by Smarty Pants and Stoner.
So Sarah Chambers on the outside. We are going to have a timeout called on the track. It is a team timeout now called by Victorian Roller Derby League.
And this timeout is brought to you by Roller Derby Elite. Elite experience skating at warp speed. RollerDerby-Elite.com is where you need to go for all of their information. So those of you that are watching the, or listening, I should say, to the audio stream only, don't forget for champs, you should really look into getting the stream, because that's where you get to see all these great replays that we're talking about. That's where you get to see all the action firsthand, and it will really help you as you're following along trying to get that bracket filled out. So if you are interested, we want you to jump into the champ seating bracket challenge with Derby on Toast, and we want you to stay tuned after the game for a Facebook live stream and the 2017 championship seating announcement that will follow the award ceremony.
Christy Demons, we had a question on Twitter if Christy Demons was still at 100% lead acquisitions, and yes, she is. 10 out of 10 for Christy Demons, 100% lead acquisition in this championship game. We are back underway with Olivia Shooten-John and Sarah Chambers still taking a seat in that 888 penalty box. So Olivia Shooten-John on the power start for Texas. We are already in the second straightaway as pack speed has increased, but Olivia Shooten-John likes that kind of a speed. So two blockers, one blocker left to go. That's Bisexual is the last line of defense. We have made our way all the way around the track, and Olivia Shooten-John finally, after almost 30 seconds, lead jammer. So, but we do have an apex jump now by Sarah Chambers.
Beautiful.
Right as she hit the back of the pack from being released. Apex jump, speed increase. Now Texas calling for that speed increase as OJ looking to put additional points on the board for Texas, checking to see where Sarah Chambers is as Sarah Chambers hits the back of the pack. And now we're going to camp out a little bit on the back. So that secondary straightaway. Yep, OJ, now everybody's kind of settling into their formations, and we're going to sit. So OJ now having to struggle against the tripod at the front. So that's that looked like trauma up there, trying to break up that tripod, also maintaining a bridge to the back of the pack. Christy Demons, not sure if that was an unintentional cover removal, as she will recycle back and around.
So this is OJ's first lead jammer status here in the game, period. And all of Olivia Shooten-John's points came in the first half on jam 4 when she was on that power jam.
So, and Olivia Shooten-John removing the helmet cover, and it looks like trying to find trauma.
And we have yet another star pass by Texas.
So not just yet. OJ still has it, and now we see that star pass. There it is. So it looked like they've kind of faked a pass a little bit. Maybe couldn't quite get it into Trauma's hand, but Trauma now the jammer for Texas. So we are going to have the jam come to a natural conclusion.
Both teams taking 4 points, so all awash. Here's the replay of that first hint of the star pass, but it looks like struggling to get through. Victoria getting in the way, and you see Sarah Chambers there off on the right being held back by number 100 from Texas at a CC Boom, who has been a rock star blocker today for Texas.
Definitely a power pack member is CC Boom. Christy Demons, we're going to wear the star now as we go into jam number 22. We are under 2 minutes in this game, so you're just now joining us and catching the very tail end of this. That's Texas in white, Victoria in blue, Freight Train wearing the star for Texas. So we are trying to see if Freight Train can just lay on those walls, but Christy Demons finding the inside. Freight Train seems to be making these holes on the outside, and the Victoria jammers see them and just take advantage.
And I gotta say, this is another example. Christy Demons really did not only an apex jump, it looks like we have a forearm penalty being called on Freight Train. She's gonna take a visit to the 888 penalty box. And as I was saying, the Victoria jamming crew really has a lot of not only rotational game that you'll see where they spin a lot on that inside, but their vertical game is really what seems to make the difference for them. Freight Train is one of those jammers who is super powerful and finds those holes on the inside, but Wftda says, I don't need holes. I'm just going to jump into the position I want to be at.
So that's something that we see a little bit with Lady Trample, who is now taking the line and wearing the star, as we are under 30 seconds on the period clock. So we will have this jam as we are coming to the 10-second mark. 5 seconds been called on the track, and Lady Trample with the power start for Wftda, as Freight Train now being commanded to stand in the 888 penalty box. So Lady Trample forced to the outside. We'll have to recycle back into turn number 4, monitored there by P. Swart. So CC Boom tried to make it all the way to the line, just wasn't able to do so. Lady Trample laterally moving across through the apex lead jammer, and Lady Trample going to call this jam off, and we are at our unofficial final. So right now we're sitting Wftda at 193, Texas at 50 for our unofficial final. This means that Wftda has clinched that number one spot. They came in the number one seed. They will leave with the number one position. Texas came in number two. They will also leave with the number two position, and we have made it final. So congratulations to Wftda for clinching the number one seed and maintaining their position. Congratulations also to Texas for such an amazing game. We are thankful for that call.
And we want to remind you guys, don't go anywhere, because we're going to have a pretty big announcement coming here at the end of the game. Not only are we going to be bringing you some information about the seeding that's happening at the championship tournament, but we're also going to have a really big news announcement about the broadcasting for championships.
I don't know what it is. Do you know what it is?
No, I don't. So we're going to have to watch as well, and you're not going to want to miss this. It's very exciting. So don't go anywhere. We've got lots more information coming. You're not quite done with this weekend of Derby.
But we are done with our gameplay. Yes. So on behalf of our broadcast crew here in Dallas for the Division I 2017 International Playoffs, thank you for joining us on WFTDA.TV this weekend and over the audio stream. We hope that we will hear you or see you at the at championships or on the stream. My name is Shady Hawkins.
I'm Scarlett O'Hurt. Yeah.
Thank you again, Justice Marshall Feelgood and Feelgood Marshall, and we will see you later.